So I want to walk you through the basic ideas about what category design is all about and how to think that way and how to how to take your company in that direction if that's something you want to do. So this is basically an overview, but some behind the scenes stuff about the book too. Just want to start out with a few reasons why it's important to think this way. And so one is everybody in this room probably knows and feels that it's way easier to start a company today than it was 20 years ago. Grab a laptop and a credit card, get on AWS, join up with somebody like Techstars. You know, a couple people can have a company up and running in no time that can compete with the giants of the world. But what that means is that if anybody has a really interesting idea in an interesting new space, it quickly looks like this, with 1,000 other companies piling in to do what you're already trying to do. So it becomes really hard to stand out unless you are establish yourselves as some kind of a leader, a thought leader, a category king in a particular space. And another reason to try to go for this idea of category king and category creation is that in any market that's really that's digital, it's a winner-take-all kind of situation. And you can measure that any way you want. Market share, you look at on-demand transportation, and Uber is the obvious category king in this space. It takes 73% of the market share, Lyft 23%. And so market value is another way you could measure it. And Airbnb in particular space worth $30-some billion. When HomeAway was sold, it was worth about $4 billion. Whether it's you measure it by total usage in the space of online storage, Dropbox kind of identified the category and came to dominate it. And even with all of Google's power and capabilities, it still only has 70% of the usage of this kind of online storage space. And another interesting reason for wanting to be a category king is the category kings tend to attract the best people. And here's a way we know about this. About a year ago, LinkedIn decided to do a study using its data to try to figure out what were the 25 companies that the most talented people in the world want to work for. And a little background story on this. When LinkedIn wanted to do this study, they ran the data, but they also brought in a woman named Susie Welch to analyze the data and write about it. Now, Susie Welch is a pretty famous business journalist. She used to be the editor of Harvard Business Review. She also happens to be married to Jack Welch, who was the former CEO of General Electric and also kind of a business character in his own right. And we didn't even really know about this project. And then one of my co-authors, Al Ramadan, got a call one day from Susie Welch saying, we're doing this study, and I happen to have been reading your book. And I noticed that if you map the companies that are landing on that list of the ones people want to work for to the idea of category kings, most of the companies on the list are identifiably category kings. And she wanted to talk to us about the dynamics and why that was. But towards the end of the interview, Al thought he'd ask, he says to Susie, well, how did you end up running across our book? And this was one of my favorite things I ever heard about the book was she said, well, my husband's Jack Welch. And Al's like, yeah, I know who Jack Welch is. And she says, well, Jeff Bezos gave your book to my husband and said, you should read this. And then my husband gave it to me and said, you should read this. So that's apparently we're floating around in some pretty high, stratospheric circles there. But the bottom line here is that is also a really good reason to want to identify yourself as this category king.